This is the Oberheim Matrix-12, my personal favorite polyphonic synthesizer. The Matrix-12 came out around 1984, 1985. I was having some power supply issues with mine. Sometimes it would not boot, other times the system would lock up during use. And I was getting the dreaded Voice 1 processor malfunction message on the display. That's just no bueno. Even with today's sophisticated access to all kinds of information, there are absolutely no documented power supply repair tips out there, anywhere. That is, until now. In this video, I am going to show you what I did to resolve my issues. I will also offer some helpful insight into how this unique power supply works, and why it is different from most other synthesizers I have encountered. Some of these tips may help you with the Oberheim Xpander as well. They are very similar. Make sure you feel confident in doing these kinds of electronics repairs. There's no shame in asking a knowledgeable friend or reputable synthesizer tech for some help. First thing, let's make sure to unplug the power cord, okay? You won't need it for these repairs. Failure to unplug this power cord could result in electrocution of yourself and your beloved Matrix-12. Next, you will want to download the power supply schematics from the internet. Make sure you have the appropriate tools for doing this kind of work. I have a Heiko 808. Even though it's discontinued, you may find a similar alternative out there. Failure to use the right kind of tools could result in overheating or damage to your circuit boards, so just get the right stuff and you'll be okay. It's worth the investment, trust me. On the Matrix-12, we are dealing with an SMPS. This means switch mode power supply. Typically, on other instruments, they use a linear power supply, and they look thus. The alternating current mains power is stepped down with a transformer. Then the AC is rectified to direct current using diodes. DC is then smooth using capacitors. Eventually, voltage regulators will output the power needed by your synth. On the Matrix-12, the first three steps remain essentially the same. Then a transistor is used to chop the current into a pulse wave. The amount of power being supplied to the system varies with this pulse width. The pulse width is controlled by a transducer chip. The chip in turn gets its input from a feedback circuit. Here, another transformer isolates any remaining noise in the power supply from the sensitive digital components of the synthesizer. And as you can guess, another round of rectifier diodes and smoothing capacitors would be needed for, you know, because you have a pulse wave going there. And lastly, the voltage regulators finally come in at the very end. Why in the world would you want to do all this? Well, number one is to decrease the heat dissipation without big, heavy, bulky heat sinks. And therefore, you know that heat is equal to energy loss. So using a switch mode power supply is more energy efficient. See, Tom was thinking green all the way back in the 1980s. Okay, normally when I start a project like this, I would disconnect the power outputs and I would use a voltmeter to verify each one. And normally I would use a scope to look for ripple in the power lines. However, this is not possible with switch mode power supplies. The supply senses the current being drawn by the load and continuously compensates it by adjusting the switching pulse width. Well, okay, it's a catch-22. I want to check the power by taking away the load, but if I take away the load, it won't power up. So what in the world is to be done about it? Well, I decided to take a more routine maintenance approach to this project. The synth is over 30 years old and needs certain preventive measures performed anyway. Maybe by performing this preventive maintenance, I would be able to have an effect on the issues that I was having. Again, be sure to unplug that synth. Don't blow yourself up. Now that you're a little bit more familiar with the Matrix-12, let's look at what I did to resolve my power supply issues. The electrolytic capacitors are over 30 years old, so I started out by replacing them with new ones. I used high-quality Nikon capacitors to do the same specs as the original capacitors. Be sure to inspect your circuit board while you're doing these things. I noticed on mine that there was a darkened area from excessive heat in a certain spot. So when you see stuff like that, you will want to... it doesn't automatically mean that it's toast, but it just means, hey, check the components in that area and make sure everything's good. On mine, I went ahead and replaced a resistor and some of the diodes in that area. After doing these things, I noticed some improvement, but the problems were still showing up. It was still not booting sometimes, and other times locking up. On closer inspection, I noticed my shunt resistors had these hairline cracks in them, so I went ahead and replaced those with metal film resistors. Lastly, I replaced the power entry module. This power entry module is where the cord plugs into the synth, but it actually contains more filtering capacitors. So I have put the Mauser order numbers for the shunt resistors and the power supply entry module in the description of this video. And now I'm happy to report that I have been using my synth all week without any issues whatsoever. No boot problems, no voice one processor malfunction BS. It just works. It's just wonderful. Hopefully these preventive measures will help you with your problems on the Matrix 12 and Xpander. If you found this video helpful, go ahead and click the like button and maybe leave a comment. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good one.